Hello everyone, this is my first live video, so forgive me any chaos and nervousness. I was thinking I can do this maybe once a week on Wednesday mornings, for me morning at least. So I can tell you a little bit about what I do and maybe we can do some quilting together. I think that would be fun. First, yeah, it's my birthday today. So first, I'm getting 29. So I got a package in the mail from an aunt who also loves quilting. So let me first open that because I'm very curious to see it. Okay. She likes second-hand store. So it's a Frisian theedoek. She's an interesting woman. Because, you know, where I'm from, in the province, the Groningen, you have a sort of friendly competition with the Frisian people. So now every time I use this to dry my stuff, I don't know. I will remember that friendly fight we have with the Frisian people. Yeah, and now, as you can see, here's my quilt wall. This is an ideal way to hang your quilting so you can design everything. Yeah. And you see here the sampler I'm working on. A sampler consists actually of a lot of different blocks. So you can see you have the pinwheel here, you have the Roman square block, you have the log cabin block. And you also have the ninth patch and the flying geese here. And if you put all those blocks together, you have a quilt that consists of many different blocks. And then it's a perfect practice thing, actually. But you've also, hi Andrea. You also see here that when you practice something, things can go wrong. Because you see that lots of the blocks are about the same size, like 20 by 20 centimeters. But some of the log cabin, some of the Roman square here, see this one? It consists of smaller blocks. That is because I am not very good at math. I do everything on feeling. And when you don't measure your quilts, sometimes they come out too small. But you shouldn't worry about that, because even if blocks are too small, you can fix it by just make more of them and connect it together. So that's a bit, yeah, that's how I quilt. That's my philosophy. Quilting is not difficult. You just have to know how to fix your mistakes. And all the other blocks you see are the right size. Yeah. So I'm now, I'm waiting for my family to arrive as well. And in that time, usually when it's my birthday, I also use it as a time to reflect on everything that has happened. And because if you look back at things, you usually see you make more progress than you actually think. And in quilting terms, that's especially true, because this year I've started Kick-Ass Quilt, so it's actually really a baby. And I've also started quilting actively again. Because I went from, this is my first quilt I made 10 years ago from scraps, and I think that started my love of working with old clothes and stuff like that. But with all my travelings and studying and stuff like that, I kind of forget about that. But this year I also started doing that again. Because the fabrics for this quilt, I collected by just going to Facebook and asking who has old clothes I can use. And then I got some people who said, I have lots of old clothes. And I went, collected it and turned it into a quilt. And I did the same for some of the demo quilts for Kick-Ass Quilts. And then I got, this one is the end result of that, from old shirts. And it has a penguin on the back. Because I like penguins. And also I made scrap quilts for my own scraps again. Like this one. It has shirt of my father. Canyon quilts. Another shirt of my father. This is an old tablecloth. This is an old dishwash towel. and another old shirt. So my reflection of this year is that I rediscovered my love of quilting with clothes. It's not only better for the environment, because if you reuse clothes, it doesn't go to landfill. It's also actually more fun, because instead of having unlimited choice in quilt shops, it can be very intimidating, because you have so many choices and all the choices look like it's perfect together. But if you work with only the few fabrics you have, you're more limited, so you force your brain to think up of new combinations. That's also how I made a laptop sleeve like this. The basis was like a shirt, but all the other fabrics are just random whatever I had. And the benefit of that is that it becomes interesting. Because if a design is too perfect, it's sometimes a bit boring. I don't know if you've ever noticed that when you go to a museum or you go to a fashion place with rugs and stuff like that. If a design is too perfect, it's usually a bit boring. You need something that doesn't seem to match, and because it doesn't seem to match, it actually makes it quite cool. And that happens with this one as well, because the pink is quite outstanding, but it works. It makes it interesting. I like quilts you keep looking at. Yeah? So that's for now everything I wanted to say. I think I have to start baking a cake for my family so they have something nice with their coffee. And I wish you all a nice day, and if you have questions, I will hear about it.